So get up.
History will show there have been some highly pedigreed winners of Hero CPL over the previous seven editions. There has been a lot of joy, celebration, and well-deserved success. Who wins it in 2020? We will know in just over 3 hours from now. Live cricket from the Brian Lara Cricket Academy in Trinidad. The final of Hero CPL 2020. Three-time champions, the Trinbago Knight Riders, and first-time finalists, the St. Lucia Zooks. Head-to-heads between these two teams, TKR well out front, 12-2. So a lot of history on which TKR can draw, but for the Zooks, about hunger. You heard from Darren Sammy and Kyron Pollard momentarily. Familiar faces with Dial, who's been slotted in for the last few games at the top, joins Cornwall. Fletcher coming in at three. Nabi and Chase have made great contributions to this. It's been a real team effort with Kugelheim and Williams, with Zahid Khan in tow as well.
The Trinbago Knight Riders, of course, no Sunil Narine. So the big news today for them, Sikandar Razza comes back in. Lindell Simmons at the top of the order, the leading run scorer for the Trinbago Knight Riders. Darren Bravo is close behind. Tion Webster in his last two matches had unbeaten knocks. Kyron Pollard, ridiculous strike rate of over 200. Dwayne Bravo, over 500 T20 wickets. And their bowlers, their spin bowlers in particular, Aki Lusail and Kari Pier, have been brilliant throughout this tournament. Ali Khan as a fast bowling option.
Umpires out in the middle for this, with the Hero plinth and the match ball. Rack attack is always going to be here. Wonderful in that semi-final. Totally obliterated the Warriors. Had a great day out. Did Cornwall and co. Mark Dale, they were quite extraordinary. In fact, player of the match, Mark Dale. Good numbers these, D.
Very much so, and he's forged a good chemistry with his partner, Mark Dale. They've tried a couple different combinations at the top of the order, St. Lucia Zooks, but they have a lot of confidence in these two. Dale high from that play of the match award in the semi-final. He will want a repeat performance all around, ball, bat in the field. Young, talented left-handed batsman.
Yep, all in sundry out, down on one knee. One fist salute in the air. Great stuff. Keel Hussain, Kari Pier, they've been superb, the spin twins. Gregory Brathwaite is at our pavilion end. He says, let's go, gents. The rack attack on strike. There's that curve. You'll be watchful on the rack. You better be. Give it a heave. Big guys looking away straight away. Here's the first runs of the final. Up and over. Bravo couldn't get this. Big man, big blade, and a big edge for four. One done, eight for none.
Credit to Rakeem Cornwall. Waited for that one. Saw it was turning away and then leaned a little bit to allow the room to cut the ball. The bounce is what did him here.
And here is Muhammad Ali Khan from the southern end. There's a bit of shape. Starts with one that swings.
The Knight Riders, 4 out of 5. Top first in totals to the Knight Riders at 10 a.m. at this venue. And the fifth going to the Zooks. 172 is what they've scored here. And all five of these highest scores were the 10 o'clock matches right here at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy. So an opportunity for the Zooks as well.
Thank you, Mr. Miller, the killer. Oh, that's a killer there, a killer blow. Middle pole out of the ground, the rack attack. is no more here in the final.
It's an El Dorado celebration, the first for the Knight Riders. Guess who? Ali Khan. Pitched in line, going through the defenses of Rakeem Cornwall and castled.
Middle pole uprooted of Cornwall. In and out. He got eight. It's 10-1. It's been shorter runs, Fletcher. Today would be a good day. Don't bowl there. Spicy's underway.
Nabi, he's been so exceptional in the last five overs. You want him to play with that freedom.
Left-handedness, Darren Ganga.
We
love it. So does Dial. Oh, we had to hit that one. Had to hit that. Mark Dial. He'll pick up a boundary. I reckon it'll race away. Yeah. And Sammy pumped. Those in blue changed their shirts, didn't they? Late in this eighth edition. Oh. That is so Andre Fletcher. Raz has just been zooped for her at maximum.
Says a lot about Fletcher's mindset. When he can come in and play a shot like this one. Opens up, keeps his eye on the ball, gets a nice swing in.
Oh, the blue man. Sixer again.
Sweet ass. Sounded really good off the middle of the bat.
Where to now, Spicy? He's at arm ball. And there's another larrup. This has gone 4-5. I love him. Big over so far.
He's making a statement here, Andre Fletcher. Had some lip service from Dwayne Bravo and Karen Pollard. As if to say, take this. Flair style, aggression shown. That's safe. And it's good to see this mindset shown by the Zooks batsman. Mark Dial, he's been watchful but positive, and Fletcher ultra aggressive in his approach.
Only two fielders allowed outside the circle, so Ali Khan taking charge of a difficult over. Tremendous style and poise from Fletcher. 50 comes up for the Zooks.
A signature shot for Fletcher, a little bit of movement down the pitch to get to the length of it, and the square drive just executed perfectly.
That is magnificent. It really is from Andre Fletcher. And perhaps he's a guy you want to take away the front foot drive from him. You don't know if Ali Khan has the pace, and he did charge him and beautifully played.
Well, if you thought the first one was good, just check this one out. Cameras, please. Deserves a shot.
Single. It completes an excellent Guardian Light power play for the St. Lucia Zooks in this big day, 60-1. Partnership of just 29 deliveries, round one to the St. Lucia Zooks.
Come on, boys. Boys, then. Yes.
That is tremendous. It really is. Quite beautiful to watch, aesthetically pleasing to be able to play that against the spin.
big gap between deep point and deep mid-off. So Dial just giving himself some room and showing it early to get into a good balanced position to open the blade, to lift it over extra cover. Classy.
I think Fowler is going to have to play a big part here. One thing that TKR do lack over the years, it has been that, I'd say extreme pace, but that genuine quick bowler who is able to push batsmen back. They've got the swing of Ali Khan and the variety of Dwayne Bravo, but they've never had experience quick bowling. 66 for one.
As you expect, he runs in. He's such an imposing figure that only bowls very medium pace with a lot of off cutters and leg cutters. It's quickly recognised that length, that if he bowls those cutters, the ball's just going to sit up. Quickest ball, 116, so probably medium's a bit generous. Slow medium.
That's with the wind. It doesn't need. It's a lovely strike from Mark Dial to end the over. 74 for one.
Mark Dial's engine is going well, so too the Hero Hunk. 60-era sponsorship.
Got it and dropped it. Oh, my goodness. You don't say that too often for Carey Pierre. And it was a sitter. He had it momentarily. He doesn't make the most of it. And 2.4 overs outside the batting power play, he goes. Forward's the man.
It's been a brilliant partnership between this pair of 67 that comes to an end with a good wrong-un. Tim Seifert just getting a glove on it and the slip making no error. So the experience of Fawad Ahmed coming to the party here in his first over. Picks up the second wicket. Dial goes for 29 off 27. It's 77 for two. Roston Chase has had a good tournament with bat and ball. He's been reliable. He's been the anchor.
Is that bounce and turn again. Still with that slip in place.
We're seeing already, just with the five balls that have been delivered, how different it would have looked if there was a left-hander at the crease. So sort of backing out the point we're trying to make up here is so much harder for the ball spinning into the bat. Or spinning away, I should say, from the bat, against spinning into the bat.
Just one off the 10th over ball by Hussain. 79 for two at the halfway mark. Time for the Angostura LLB drinks break, courtesy Bamani.
But the one thing I would say, Danny Morrison, is that the St. Lucia Zooks have only had two half centuries throughout this tournament. And look at that shot placement. And both of these half centuries have come from this man, Roston Chase. So he has that ability to score, as he has just demonstrated here.
It's a flight. Long half volley. Just a little bit too much from forward. Yeah, but he's classical, isn't he? Such an orthodox player as Roston Chase. Skipper. He's just going to take his time here, as Pollard so loves to do. It's all part of the strategy, ploy. Just make the batter wait a little bit longer. Uh-oh. Oh, and he's done it. Yeah, time for the celebration. Big El Dorado one. Yeah, they're going to go crazy. And he's pumped. The big guy. Skipper's done it.
Stepping up.
giving himself some room, trying to go for the hero maximum. But just not enough connection. Darren Bravo in the way. Republic Bank classic catch. That had six written all over it. Look at that El Dorado celebration from the Trinbago Knight Riders captain. Elation, jubilation here at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy. Fletcher goes for 39. The Zooks 89 for 3.
Here we go. Yeah, Felter could sense it. Got 100 up in style. Boom. 105 for 3. South side of Trini. See the shirt flapping there of Roston Chase, and he's flapping with the blade. He just sensed those two dot balls, possibly something was going to give. Wonderful stroke. Beautiful cricket shot. So sensible in its execution. Yeah, the breeze has certainly picked up here.
Yeah, we have had 13 overs so far, Danny Morrison. Kieran Pollard continues to bowl. We haven't seen Dwayne Bravo with the ball just yet. He's in the field. He's a short third man.
They swapped it around. There's an outside edge. Farward thought Lendl had it. Lendl said, no, you can have it. Oh, yeah, hustle, hustle. A couple of old boys trying to chase it.
Excellent running. They got through for that one. Fawad Ahmed was in the chase. So it's going to be a challenge. And if the St. Lucia Zooks play it smart for the remaining six overs, then they can get up to that 175, 180 mark. Which in a final, Danny Morrison runs on the board. You never know.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear, is it? Gone. Yes! Ran out of patience. They've let Pollard get another one with his change-ups. Key moment in this final.
I'm trying to whip it on the one side, more height than distance. And a simple catch for Tion Webster. Yeah. Karen Pollard. Well, he gets another one for the Trinbago Knight Riders. And you can see the passion on his face. 115 for 4. The Zooks chase goes for 22.
Superb cricketer, very experienced, Muhammad Nabi, Afghan international, comes out and joins his brother, Najibullah.
Give yourself some time. Still 5 overs after this one. That's what he would be saying on the St. Lucia Zooks camp.
Made it look so easy, and it's very brief from Muhammad Nabi here,
going for a hero maximum of his second delivery and not getting the connection that he would have liked. And Darren Bravo took a smart catch in the deep, very close to that advertising board, but good movement, getting in line, and good hands from Darren Bravo. Nabi goes for 2 off 3 deliveries, 117 for 5 now. Slip in position, bat pad, pressure on.
Jack Kurtseer is out of here.
Coming,
holy heck, second ball. Captain has come to the party.
And Darren Sammy needs no second invitation to swing to the line of that one. That's his favorite shot. Over wide, long on. Rolls back into the stands from Darren Sammy, so his confidence will be boosted and buoyed by that magnificent blow.
They've still got the personnel, haven't they? Two at the crease are very capable finishers. And Javel Glenn is also a good striker of the ball, and so is Scott Kugeline.
Just threw his bat at this one. We'll get 4. Wit on off, but pace on that ball. And that's a good approach by Zadran.
and he's got the protection deep, backward point, deep cover and a deep mid off for it, but Zadran is getting the face of the bat open enough so he could get it fine, which challenged the deep backward point.
Finds the fielder. Two dot delivery, stand the over. This is quite good by the Knight Riders. 129 for five. That's beautiful. That's powered for Hero Maximum. Where does he get the power, Zadran?
Short ball sitting up wide of off stump, but just the hands through the ball are so quick from Zadran. He manages to slap it.
That's out. It was straight. Was a heavy offside feel, and you'd think that the line might be outside the off stump. Hussein goes straight and gets his man.
Beautifully bowled. Beautifully bowled, just beating the inside edge, catching Sammy on the front pad. And it would have cannoned into the stumps, all three of them. So Sammy's stay was brief. He goes for eight. It's 137 for six.
Dogs this one. Gets all of it a little bit straighter. Covers any turn on offer. And strikes a boundary early in his innings. Jabal Glenn. Talk about bowling. Pollard adds another one. Another wicket to his list of six. Goes to seven now. And it's crucial at this stage of the innings. Just denting this Zook's batting lineup further.
Pollard full of experience. Just the off cutter. Holding in the wicket. Glenn looking to launch it down the ground and just getting a top edge. Glenn goes for nine off seven. It's 148 for seven.
The distance, a man settles, and another wicket for Pollard. Make that four.
Najibullah Zadran going to his favoured side, the leg side. But because of the lack of pace from Pollard, he couldn't get it to the boundary. Raza making no error at deep backward square. Eldorado celebration for Pollard. Zadran goes for 24, it's 149 for 8.
Piece off the ball yet again from Pollard. Brings up the 150 for the Zooks.
Here's Rick Williams on strike.
This might just be another wicket. Fielder settles, doesn't get there. Pair was running around, so too Darren Bravo. Pollard clearly disappointed.
It'll just be a couple runs.
Indecision. Right. Good work by the Knight Riders. Tian Webster doing the fielding and Pollard effecting the run out.
From the very first ball, when Kugelein got off strike, to the very last ball. And they're all over the place. What is it with bowlers and running between the wickets? Really? It's not that hard, Ian Bishop. Williams goes for three. It's 154 for nine.
Ali Khan, last delivery. Goes full and castled. Well, the Knight Riders, they've brought back into this contest. Just when you felt that Zooks would capitalize on the full complement of 20 overs, they're bowled out.
Well, the perfect finish for TKR. They've clawed their way back into this contest. It looked at one point the Zooks were going to get around the 170, 180 mark, and perfect delivery from Ali Khan. It's where you need to be bowling to number 11. And there it is, the Eldorado celebration taking off the Zooks trademark celebration.
Just wonder whether that was intended or not.
There are lots of starts in the innings. Dial and Fletcher had an excellent partnership. One with 67. And then starts from Chase, Zadran. You felt had to bat deeper for them to get a higher total. In the end, the Knight Riders, well, they're able to bowl out the Zooks with just 154. That 67-run partnership I spoke about being the most significant between Fletcher and DL. And after that, 26 and 20.
Two wickets for Ali Khan, two Yorkers, too bold for him. Pollard quite brilliant, stepping up in the absence of Bravo, picking up 4 for 30 off his four overs. 2 for 22 for Farwood Ahmed. A good all-round bowling performance from TKR.
As we look forward to the second half of this contest, the Knight Riders will need 155 runs to win. If they are to do that, we'll just have to wait and see.
So in this final, TKR will need 155, the Zooks needing to defend them. Lendl Simmons, with all his experience, really good knock in the last game. It was as confident as you would have seen him. And the less experienced Tion Webster also played a good hand in the semi-final victory over the Talawas. Samuel Badri, this man has been outstanding.
Throughout the tournament, he's been really good for the St. Lucia Zooks. His adaptability has been brilliant. They need him to get early wickets in this final match of the Hero CPL 2020.
And he does get these early breakthroughs. Two slips in place. Four runs. Not far from Zahir Khan at short fine leg.
Confident from his last knock unbeaten in that 10-wicket victory. Seems to be switched on for this final, Lindell Simmons.
Dropped it. Again, it's that shape, and Webster lost his positioning. 7 without loss. Here's Nabi, watch for the outswing.
Yeah.
Good run.
So whilst the St. Lucia Zooks will be looking for early wickets, the Trinbago Knight Riders, on the other hand, will be looking for a partnership.
Gets that in the gap and gets a boundary.
A little bit too full perhaps from Mohammed Nabi. And hitting with the angle, with the turn. And he's very confident. Tion Webster, two unbeaten 40s in his previous two matches. And hitting the winning runs in that semi-final. So he's buoyed.
Ross and Chase with a deep mid-wicket and long on.
Just goes to show, Bish, that single, whenever you refuse it, something happens the next delivery, and it puts pressure on the younger, less experienced Tion Webster.
Well, it could be the end of him. And if you reflect on that single refused, it's a Republic Bank classic, and you go back to the refusal of runs and the end result that can happen.
Wonderful start here for the St. Lucia Zooks. That man, Ruston Chase, again, his smarts and his cunningness coming to the fore. Good catch. Don't discount that. From Kestrick Williams, a Republic Bank classic catch and an El Dorado celebration. Tion Webster, the first wicket to go for the Knight Riders for 5. 13 for 1.
seeing again. A shot, that is.
You're really elegant and classical and graceful from Tim Seifert, of course, New Zealander against New Zealander. Seifert up against his countryman, Scott Kugelein. But a really elegant shot from the wicketkeeper batsman.
That was very, very quiet. Very, very quiet indeed.
Yeah, Kugelein strikes again. Top of the log now in terms of most wickets. Scott Kugelein. And what a recovery from the previous delivery that went for four. A little bit anticlimactic, but they knew straight away the St. Lucia Zooks. And that's two early wickets now. Now four of them in the defense of this 154 that they said. Seifert goes for four, 19 for two. So some tension in that Trinbago Knight Riders. He can be doing bravo as a batsman, Raza as well.
Masterful. Really casual in its process, but the impact superb. Hero maximum.
It's always going to happen. I just praised him about his control, and he presents a half volley. Darren Bravo wouldn't miss out on that. He loves to hit those out of the park. Such a nice free flow of the bat.
One to get on the power play. Can they snaffle another one here, the Zooks? Lendl. Simmons, downtown, that is so sweet. Yeah, Kugelein, no chance with this one. Nicely struck. Liked it, Moods. Too straight. Keswick. Run away. Yeah, it does. It just had enough on it with that extra quicker delivery from Keswick. Horton boundary. Needy inside the power play. So racing away. A finish at 40 after the power play. Remember, the Zooks were 60 for one after their Guardian Life power play. 40 for two. Chase just sorting his field. Want to be precise now that the power play is over. Ball still at slip. Aaron Sammy hunting up on the drive and the covers. Flight. Lovely deception of a dip at the end. Bowling. Got to stop those. Rack. Create some pressure. Some more responsibility for Brother Bravo coming in late. And then, of course, Pollard himself, who's been so dominant. Yeah, he's been a good signing for the Zooks, Kiwi. Still ticking away. Can close out this over all right. Four singles, hasn't been too bad, even with a couple of short deliveries, and quite come out as you'd like. So five singles. 50 up here for TKR for the loss of two. 10 runs off 18 balls. A bit quicker that last one. And again, disappears. Good chunk of it. Rumbo bottle's got a beating.
So a regulation pace delivery on that occasion from Nabi. And hitting the 15-year-old bottle of El Dorado.
Save some for me.
But he'll be as aware as anyone that he needs to continue to take wickets. Because TKR have got the power hitters down the line.
Now we've had 10. Halfway in this innings, the chase. The Angus Door LLB drinks break is on. Thank you, Gregory Brathwaite. And it is 59 for 2 here.
For two after 10. Darren Sammy trying to inspire his troops. Sammy for the first time with the ball in this innings. I want to make the point about St. Lucia Zooks. We saw them against the Barbados Tridents when they scored 92. They defended it. And then against the Talawas, Bravo gets the better of Darren Sammy. He measured him. Well, he's showing his preference for the Trinidad stand. Hero maximum to end the over. 68 for 2.
Kyron Pollard, Vin Bravo, Sikandar Raza. All in the shed still.
Picked up nicely. Has the distance. Only just fingertips from Navi. Away in the gap. Lendl Simmons on fire. Consecutive boundaries now for the Knight Riders.
At the top of the list now in terms of the most runs in 2020. Hero CPL. So he's come to the party at the right time.
Make that 50 to Lendl Simmons. 19th half century. What an occasion to get it. Putting his team in firm control. You can see he's passionate about his team, the Knight Riders, and the occasion. 84 for 2.
Crucial two deliveries in this over. Only one run from the over. This is going to remain a very good over for the Zooks. Or can Lendl Simmons finish on a high? Side edge, Simmons. He wants strike.
Don't want to give him any jinx.
Is it the right decision, Lendl Simmons? Just eases it
to long off for one. Just two runs from the over. An excellent over for Ruston Chase to end his spell. One for 13. It's 86 for 2.
17 dot balls and just the 13 runs with the one wicket from Ruston Chase. And the St. Lucia Zooks are chasing their first title.
Not this one. Bravo, quick to pounce on it. Such a genuine six hitter. That's a response. Doesn't work, the mind games. Bravo is switched on mentally. His execution very well.
Brings up the 100 for the Trinbago Knight Riders, and the move hasn't worked for Darren Sammy. 15 runs off the over. Too short, just way too short from Jabal Glenn. Darren Bravo enjoyed this one. Just look at his reaction, his celebration after hitting that six. So some gamesmanship on show. Yeah, this Trinbago Knight Riders batting has demonstrated the art of batsmanship, how you construct and structure an innings, how you organize the way you want to play. And Darren Bravo, in this innings, well, he started off really slowly, but he was able to catch up, and he's still there. And that has been eminently missing in this tournament.
To reload. Well, what Kyron Pollard has done, and he said it before, doesn't really try to compete with opposition teams. Tries to insert dominance based on the strengths within this Knight Riders team. delivery. This is not good for the Zooks.
Just expressing that disappointment to him. Force Darren Bravo to score through the offside. That's the message.
Would have been a wide. Bravo reaching for it. 9 runs from the over. 110 for 2 after 15.
Cook line has one more. This is turning out to be a spectacular over. You get the feeling he will finish well. Nabi has one more. Keswick one. Zahir still has 3 available. Don't think we'll see Glenn or Sammy. Brilliant over. Brilliant with just one delivery left. These are the overs that shift the balance of power in an innings and match and tournament. Big delivery this. Really do feel that the balance of power, the trophy could depend on how this over finishes.
Asking rate has just clocked over tens because of this over, Bish.
Simmons running is lackadaisical. He's missing out on key runs. 114 for 2.
This is the guy, a lot of us up here in the Combox have been thinking, needed to be on possibly slightly earlier.
This could be a fantastic move here by Sammy. No, goes away for 4. And you go back to the first over, that's Harry Campbell. There were about 3 or 4 short deliveries in it. He's lost his length today so far.
Got to give credit to Simmons. He went across early. He actually made a statement and went onto the offside. That's where he's going. And yes, sir, it's gone all the way. He's picked his moment here, Lendl. He is taking on Zahir Khan, who's then now gone round the wicket and travelled.
It's so far the best in finals history. I don't know if you saw Darren Bravo do a jig.
Right in the slot. He looks around back at Rakeem and goes, how about your celebration now, boys? Yeah, that's what I think of that. Choke on that, Keswick. Oh, there's another one. Yeah, he's rubbing it in. 50 to Darren Bravo. What a great innings.
11th in Hero CPLs for Darren Bravo. Paced himself early in the innings, but he is a 6-hitting monster.
Needs some drama here from Kugelheim, the Kiwi. Needs to knock over these 2 set men. What a great stick he's got in his hand. Ah, yes. Sounded so good. Went miles. Big underdogs for sure, but they've been so united and such a good vibe in the Zooks camp. Oh, clubbed away over extra. One bounce into the rope, start rejoicing, and they do. Ah, you betcha. Where's the music now?
Here's 4 of them. Here's 4 of them. And they're doing the Zooks dance in the middle.
And as Darian Bishop said, what a 6-hitting masterclass it's been. Dominant. Suddenly just flicked the switch and they went. In the last few overs, they have cut loose.
2 to get. A nation rejoices. A franchise celebrates. TKR fans.
fans across the globe celebrate with their team a fourth CPL trophy for the Trinbago Knight Riders. And the first Hero CPL played behind closed doors post-pandemic goes to the home franchise. They win by 8 wickets here at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy in South Trinidad. No Narine, no problem. What a victory for the people of Trinidad and Tobago. Excellence personified.
Loving it. Job done here in 2020. The standouts, Lendl Simmons, 84 not out from 49 and 58 not out of 47. Darren Michael Bravo with a six-hitting exhibition. Six sixes, two fours. Simmons hit four sixes and eight fours. Look at that, like a beacon. 138 from 91. Partnership of the final for sure. Bowling figures, Sammy B alongside.
Early wicket for Scott Kugelein and Ruston Chase, and you felt at that point in time the St. Lucia Zooks may have created an upset, but nothing else of note from the other bowlers. Nabi was economical, but the batting off the Trinbago Knight Riders really amazing. 154 the Zooks got to in 19.1, the Knight Riders in 18.1, 157 for two. Knight Riders win by 8 wickets.
Yeah, brilliant moments. This is what you play for in sport, moments like these, championship moments. And the 2020 Hero CPL champions, the Trinbago Knight Riders, well led by Karen Pollard.
Celebrations. They are champions of 2020 TKR.